Praise the Lord. Reggie Knucklehead here, a.k.a. Brother Libby Jr. Brothers and sisters, we turn our Bibles to 2 Chronicles chapter 36. We'll be looking at verses 15 and 16. And it reads, "And the Lord God of their fathers sent to them by his messengers, rising up betimes and sending, because he had compassion on his people and on his dwelling place. But they mocked the messengers of God and despised his words and misused his prophets until the wrath of the Lord arose against his people till there was no remedy." May the Lord add a blessing to the reading, to the hearing, to the admonition, to the application, to the distribution of this great word taken from the greatest book that man could ever possess. And my brother, this is God's word. We give God all the honor, all the glory, all the praise in the precious name of his Son, our Lord and Savior. Praise the Lord, amen. Praise the Lord. Hear the ball, shout out of my God. Hear the ball, hear the ball, shout out of my God. Hear the ball, shout out of my God. Brothers and sisters, we see in God's people for 1500 years, for 15 centuries, God's people was subjected to a message that was demonic, that was satanic, that was not of God. And they were subjected to this message and to the likes where when they would hear this message, they would hear this demonic, satanic, evil, ugly, lied message where the listeners, God's people, it would affect their lives in such a way, affect their lives in a negative way, biologically, physiologically, emotionally, mentally, and even spiritually, even physically, where it would leave the listeners who would listen to this demonic message, where they would be, where they would be poor, where they would be brokenhearted, where they would be captive, held captive to this message that would make them feel guilty, that would make them feel shame, where it would make them feel under condemnation, that captivity. A message that they were listening to for 1500 years, where they would be blind to the reality, and not only that, they would be bruised physically. But we see in 2 Chronicles chapter 36, the writer conveys that the Lord God, the capital L, capital O, capital R, capital D, the covenant-keeping God, and God, the creator of heaven and earth, he loved his people. He had compassion for his people, that he sent messengers. He sent preachers. He sent men to carry out his message. His message. That spoke of God's love, of God's forgiveness, of God's mercy, of God's peace, of God's joy. And this message that God was sending out with these messengers that was preaching his word was the message of grace. And what saw it happen it, as 2 Chronicles chapter 36 described, there were those who opposed God's prophets, the Lord's prophets, who were preaching the gospel of grace. And such that they, when it came in opposition, that what happened, the remedy was no longer available for that moment. But But God loves his people. He got and we see this love was demonstrated. This love was declared. This love was displayed through his son, our Lord, our Savior, and soon to come in King Jesus Christ, where we see Dr. Luke, a medical doctor, a scientist, who recorded in his letter of Luke chapter 4, where he spoke about how our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, when all was said and done, when he went to his hometown to preach a message at his synagogue on the Sabbath day, and that Sabbath day it was a day of rest, where he came and he was the speaker for that, the preacher for that time. And he opened up, and when he got up there at the pulpit, and he opened up the Bible, and he turned, where a great man of God who preached the gospel of grace, Isaiah, turned to his book, and he looked to the crowd, he looked to the listening audience, and he preached this message. He said, "The Spirit of the Lord," the capital L, capital O, capital R, capital D, "is upon me." This is what our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ was saying when he was reading from a great man of God, Isaiah. He said, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me." He said this, to preach the gospel of grace to the poor. And so when Jesus preached the gospel of grace to the poor, they weren't poor, they became full. And when Jesus said this, to preach the gospel to the poor, to heal the brokenhearted. So they went from being, and when Jesus was preaching that message, they went from being brokenhearted to feeling good. And then Jesus went on to say, reading and sharing this message. He said to preach deliverance to those who are captive. Those who are captive to sin, the condemnation, guilt, shame. They went from captivity to being free. Jesus then goes on to say to set sight to those who are blind. They were blind to reality, listening to that demonic, evil message, but now they are set to see and see. So they went from being blind to being focused to the things of God. Then Jesus also mentions that the next one, when he said to set liberty to them that are bruised. So they went from being bruised from listening to this evil demonic message. They went from bruised to now fortified and to the things of God, to be strengthened by the things of God. Then Jesus goes on to say this, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord, our Savior, and soon to come King Jesus Christ. And that was the gospel of grace. And then he closed the book, and he sat down, and he said to those listening audience, scripture has been fulfilled. And this is the year 2021. Believer in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, in Christ, in spirit. The same message that Jesus preached is the same message that the Apostle Paul said in Galatians chapter 2, verse 20 and 21. I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I. Christ lives in me. And the life that I live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God who loves me and gave his life for me. I do not frustrate the grace of God, because when Jesus Christ, when you the preaching of the gospel of grace, you go from being poor to being full. You go when you hear the preaching of the gospel of grace, you go from brokenhearted to feeling good. When you hear the gospel of the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, you go from being a captive to the things that are holding you back to being free in Christ. When you hear the gospel of grace, you go from being blind to reality, blind to the things that are not of God, and then you are now focused to the things of God, how much he loves you, how much he's forgiven you of all your sins, how much you have eternal life. When you believe on our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, you are saved. And once you're saved, you're always saved. And then to set liberty to them that are bruised, you go from being bruised to being fortified and strengthened in the things of God. And when you hear that message, God is glorified and magnified. You are fortified, sanctified, and edified. And the kingdom of darkness, praise the name of the Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, is vilified and nullified. Praise the Lord. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you. May the Lord lift up his countenance to you. May the Lord give you his peace. And I commend you all to God and to the word of his grace, which is able to build you up an inheritance to those who are sanctified in the precious name of his Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. And unto him that is able to keep you from falling, present you faultless in the presence of his glory, both glory, majesty, dominion, power, both now and forevermore. Hear them all. Shout out. Yeah, yeah, oh God. Hear them all. Oh, yeah. Woo. And both now and forevermore. Praise the name of his Son, our Lord, our Savior, and sooner coming King Jesus Christ. Scripture has been fulfilled. Praise the Lord. God bless you. God be loved.